So remember, we're writing it from our perspective on what you think. Kind of when we put ourselves in the place automatically of the mother or of the daughter. Now we're going to continue that activity, but we're going to flip it. But right now we're going to practice with just seeing this quote. Okay? Write down, what do you think that means? Why is the baby never going to wear those shoes? Are you the baby? Are you the mother? Are you the father who's like, why doesn't that baby wear the shoes I bought? Are you, look at perspective. Sometimes when we view text, we have to see which character's perspective are we looking at. Are we looking at it from the narrator's perspective? Are we looking at it from the antagonist, the protagonist? What are we doing in that book? So what are some reasons why a baby doesn't wear their shoes? Maybe that's your perspective. What do you think?
They
can't walk yet?
No.
Or they don't fit, or what else? When my kids were young, you know when you go to, sometimes you don't even have babies, don't you? I thought their stuff, they're so cute. And I have boys, but I still look at little girls and be like, oh, look how cute this is. And how many people kind of look at that? So sometimes we buy things because it's cute, but baby's not going to wear their shoes. And then they just kick them off, and then it's a little baby. It's a little hard to put shoes on a baby. So maybe this mom's thinking, maybe this mom bought these cute things, and she's like, Chris, I want to put them on. She's going to put their socks on. Or what could be something else, a reason why the baby never wears their shoes? Always kick them off. What else? Why do you have clothes that you don't wear or shoes you don't wear? You're not comfortable? You're a little baby. I don't know. Would you want to have shoes on? Okay. What's another reason? Sometimes if we don't know how to interpret things, make a connection to yourself. Why don't I wear something that is in my closet, and at one point I bought it? And if you change your mind about it, doesn't fit anymore. Like you were hoping you fit into those shoes or that dress. Sometimes you like it, but somebody else tells you, oh, that doesn't look so good on you. And then you're influenced by what your peers think, especially, you know, at your age. So Ernest Hemingway wrote it's a very short story. It's only a 6-word story. Here we have 4. And it's about baby shoes never worn. And in 6 words, he tells you why this baby never wore it. So right now we're predicting. And we're going to finish reading the story. And we're going to go back. And then we're going to look at what we wrote at that point so we can see if we predicted correctly. So put this aside. And then what we're going to do is, you know what? Flip it over. Using this as a model, can you think of something with only 4 words that if you wrote it down, somebody may not be able to interpret? Or may be able to interpret with different meanings? And once again, what we're practicing here is looking at things from different perspectives. Like, for example, once again, remember the example, I hope she'll be a fool. The worst thing a girl can be in this world is a beautiful little fool. Or think of a book that we've read this year. Things Fall Apart, Like Water for Chocolate, Night. Is there something that somebody said that somebody else may not be able to describe. The first time we read night, remember? Why? Why does God do this? Why is this happening? Why? And we discussed that that meant rhetorical language, but sometimes some students said, this man's confused if he doesn't understand why. But our perspective is, we historically, we know what happened during the Holocaust. We know everything that happened to them. But now, Eli is currently in that position, and he's trying to figure out, why is this happening? And the whole book was about what? How would you kind of describe his journey in that book? Think about it for a minute. Anybody want to share what they think?
I would say like it shaped him and made him the man that he is now or was, because all the things that he went through kind of shaped his mindset and put him on the right thoughts. Like, he didn't believe in God as how much he used to in the beginning, but at the end he kind of, he didn't question God, but he knew what had happened and why they let that happen.
Okay. So he was trying to figure out what the reason was. Because he needed to have a reason in order to understand what was going on. Kind of like in Water for Chocolate. He said he needed to know a reason why she couldn't marry Pedro, and obligation to tradition wasn't enough for her. And when they were castrating the chicken, she said, does anybody remember what she said about comparing herself to the chicken? That's okay, because he's looking at it from a different perspective. She says, why couldn't I be the one who was moving? Because then she'd know why Pedro couldn't marry her. She could never have children. So at least she could justify the sense of tradition and obligation just wasn't enough for her. She had to understand. But she fulfilled her obligation, she fulfilled her duty, but she was always trying to ask why. And anybody have an opinion on that? As far as the why?